Hello guys, today we are going to talk about something on Hall effect. I mean that is very very important topic as far as your basics of electronics is concerned. So let me tell you one thing, what is basically a Hall effect? You know, as we can see here in this particular diagram, Hall effect, it is the process leading to the development of a voltage across one of the faces of a semiconductor slab when a crossed electric field and magnetic field is applied across the other two pairs of the faces of the slab. Now, as we can see clearly in this particular diagram, this is the semiconductor slab. Now, prior to this particular is the semiconductor slab where I have shown here how the three-dimensional pictures are there, like how the in X direction, Y direction, and Z direction the field it is being there. Now what happens in Z direction, as we can see here, the magnetic field it is being generated, and this is nothing but I have noted as BZ. And if the length and width I have shown here is nothing but length is L and width is W, and we have applied here is the voltage that is called applied voltage. I am applying across the this between the slabs of this particular semiconductor. And simultaneously also from the other two faces of the slab, we had to generate the VH. That is nothing but we call it as Hall voltage. This is as we call it as Hall voltage. So what happens here? It can be used to distinguish between N-type and P-type semiconductors. Measure majority carrier concentration and minority carrier concentration. Now the effect can also be used to develop the magnetic probe of a circuit. Applications, various applications are there. Now here in this particular figure, it shows the schematic diagram to explain the Hall effect. Now as we can see here in this particular diagram, current Ix flows through the semiconductor in X direction. And by that time also a magnetic field that I have already discussed, that is BZ, is applied in Z direction. Charge carriers present in the semiconductors experience a force due to that particular magnetic field. Now this magnetic force is felt in minus Y direction. That means the Y direction, as we can clearly see here, this is the Y direction. Obviously there will be an automatic opposite polarity of force will be produced from minus Y direction by both the electrons and holes. Now in an N-type semiconductor, now if we talk about in N-type semiconductor, what will happen is N naught, it will be greater than of P naught. So automatically what will happen, a buildup of electrons would take place at Y is equal to zero surface, that is here. So for a P-type semiconductor, again similarly, what will happen is P naught will be greater than of N naught. The buildup will be of holes on the Y is equal to zero surface. So automatically what will happen? The resulting force on the charge carriers due to this induced electric field would be steady state, exactly balanced by the magnetic field. That is the magnetic field which will ultimately balance both of the sizes. Thus at equilibrium we can write Q Ey equals to the product of Q Vx Bz, where Ey it is the electric field, that is the electric field which is be produced in the Y direction, as we can see here. And it is called Hall voltage. The corresponding voltage is called Hall voltage, designating the Hall voltage as VZ. So we can write the Hall voltage as the product of EH into the W, that is this one, the width of the slab. Similarly, this can be written as EY into the product of W, that is width of the slab, where EH, it is assumed to be positive in plus Y direction, and VH, that is this one, is considered positive if it has the polarity as shown in the figure. Now, if we see further cases, that means we need to find out the Hall voltage and Hall coefficient. Here from this particular figure, we need to understand certain things, that how exactly and what is the mathematics are there in between of it, in order to find out VH and RH. So for a P-type semiconductor, what we need to have, if you please see over here, so for a P-type semiconductor, Hall voltage will be positive, and for a N-type semiconductor, the Hall voltage will be negative. That is the first point we need to remember. Thus, the polarity of Hall voltage, it can be used to determine the type of extrinsic semiconductor or intrinsic semiconductor. Now, if you plan it out, the expressions, if you say the expressions as figure expression 1 and expression 2, then what we will do is, using expression 1, in expression 2 we can find out VH. So VH, we can write it as VX into W BZ, right? Now this we can make at equation 3. Now for a P-type semiconductor, we need to find out the current density. That in other tutorials also we told you that how to find out the current density, that is nothing but Jx. So as we all know, for a P-type semiconductor, the current density, you can write it down as the product of E P into the V dx. Now which further from there we need to find out what is V dx. Find out the expression of V dx is Jx by E into P. So if you place the value of individual Gx, sorry, Jx, we need to find out the value of Ix, because this particular current, which is to be flown again in between of the two slides of this particular semiconductor slide, that we need to find out. So in order to find this particular Ix, here we need to find out the Vdx. So Vdx we can write down as E into P. So that is of nothing but W into D, which can further be written as, let us assume this whole product, it is as Vx. Now what is Vdx is the drift velocity, and the product Wd, it represents the relevant area and E is the magnitude of electron charge, we all know. So putting all these expressions from equation 3 into equation 2, we can get the value of VH. So if you do it from this particular expression, if you place it at equation 4, so if you place the value over here, what I can find is VX will be equal to of IX into BZ, that is this one, divided by of EPT, which further I can write it out at IX BZ divided by T into RH. Now, from how we are getting this RH? RH is, you know, nothing but that is the main coefficient. You know, this is the very, very important one that we had to assume this RH. Now, this particular RH is nothing but the Hall coefficient. That is our prime concern to find out RH. So, this is how we can find it out, RH. Now, if you quickly look at it, where we need to find out VH, so here we need to mention where RH is 1 by E into P for P-type semiconductor, and RH will be of obviously of minus 1 by En, the reason I have already told you. So this will be for N-type semiconductor, that you need to remember, which further yields the value of P is nothing but IX into BZ divided by of E into D into what I am getting from there is VH, right? So thus the majority carrier concentration can be determined from the knowledge of current, magnetic field and Hall voltage using the expressions of the further. We can say for N-type semiconductors, we can write down VH will be of minus IX into BZ divided by the product of N into E into D. Further, we can find it out, N will be nothing but IX BZ divided by ED into Hall voltage. Since Hall voltage is negative for electrons, electron concentration arrived at the equations in the top is positive as expected. So the current density also can be expressed from these further expressions, what we have achieved from here, also to these expressions, which is nothing but expression 5 and expression 6, further expression 7. So here we can find it out, Jx is nothing but the product of Ep, mu p, Ex. Where what is mu p? Mu p is the low field Hall mobility. So this expression, that is the final expression, that is, let us we make it as expression of 8, it can be rewritten as Ix by W into D is nothing but equals to of Ep mu p Vx by L. So can we write it like this way? You please verify the diagram from this. So here width and length is there, so automatically the ratio will come as like this. So which further leads to the value of mu p is as Ix L divided by the whole product. So similarly, the corresponding expressions of mu n can also be find out for an n-type semiconductor is Ix into L divided by En Vx and the width of Wd. So this is how all these major expressions we need to find it out. And the remaining expression, which is very, very important, that is the Hall coefficient, which I have told you many times. That Hall coefficient, here we are assuming the Hall coefficient, which is nothing but Rh. We need to remember this Rh will be equal to 1 by Ep. And obviously Rh is minus 1 by En for n-type semiconductor and for p-type semiconductor respectively. And further, from the above expression, if you place the value, we can easily obtain the value of Hall voltage. So these are the major important factors and parameters we need to find out if we discuss the Hall effect, because from Hall effect we need to find out the values of Hall coefficient and Hall voltage. These are the major two important parameters that we need to remember, that how we are obtaining this. You have to go through the further expressions, this mathematical expression, that is very, very important in your derivations of Hall effect. So that's all for the tutorial of Hall effect and Hall voltage. Further, in the upcoming tutorials, we will see what is the other effects also we can see in such kind of semiconductors. What are the activities are there? What are the transposition of semiconductor actually is flowing in a slab, if you take out those slab from one side to other side. Thank you for this tutorial. Hope you like it.